Orloff felt the pressure coming. Mario Ferraro lays it on. Kane threw a shot up high on Gudas. That's got to be against Kane.
Oh, yeah. And that's why Ovi going after Kane. Kane is often the penalty minute leader for this team. He led them last year, Joe. And once again, he could be in some hot water for that high cross check to the head of Gudas of the Caps being looked at the bench.
Radko still in need of attention as the officials get in there to separate Ovechkin from Kane. Brendan Dillon was in there as well. Tough customer.
This could be a 5-minute major to Kane. We'll see how they sort this out.
Gudas seated now at the bench. Kane escorted to the box with the Caps in control 5-2. This is what we're talking about. Bang.
Yeah. And then he hit his head on the boards.
So they're now reviewing what has been delivered as a major penalty to Evander Kane. It's subject to review.
And they will review to make sure it's a 5-minute major, which I called right off the bat because it's a headshot, Joe. This is the best angle. Definitely targeted up high. Targeted the head. To me, it's a 5-minute major in game misconduct. This is sort of the Vegas rule, right? Remember last year, the centerman took a 5-minute major and the Sharks came back and beat Vegas right off a faceoff. So I call it the Vegas rule, where you're now allowed to look at 5-minute major calls and make the correct decision on the ice, which
referees
they're trying now.
Marc Joannette and Jean Hébert are having a look at the video. The call assessed on the ice was a major to Evander Kane. Radko Gudas has made his way to the Caps' dressing room tunnel. The Capitals, by the way, do not have an extra defenseman on this trip.
Correct.
Jean Hébert will speak.
The review, number 9 being set, it's a 5-minute major for elbowing and a game misconduct.
Evander Kane's night will end early.